Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. First of all, apologies, I could not upload any free add-ons in the last 2 weeks. Actually, I was sick and in a hospital, but now I'm feeling a little better, so hopefully the free add-ons will be back by this week or the next week. But till then, let's keep these life updates aside and talk about this new add-on. It's called Color Frame Renders and it allows you to quickly generate colorful wireframe renders for your objects. So let me show you how it works inside Blender. So here we have this free model from the Chocoper store which we will be using as an example. So the first thing you need to do is enable the preview by pressing this preview button. And now you can start adding colors to all these objects by using this set color option. So let's try that. You can also add random colors to all the selected objects by using this random colors option. So let's try that also. You can change the seed value from here to generate more combinations. You can even use color palettes from Coolers or Color Hunt by simply copying the link of the color palette and holding down control by clicking the random colors option. So let's try that. Make sure the objects are selected. And as you can see, all these colors are from this palette. And you can change again the seed value from here to generate more combinations. You can even assign different colors based on the dimension of the object. So let's try that using this random colors by dimensions. Also hold down control to use the color palette. And as you can see, let's change the seed value from here. All these larger objects get same color, all these medium size objects get the similar color, and all these smaller objects get the similar color. You can even do random color space collections if you want. And then we have these three lighting setups. So these are basically same as these three lighting setups. And let's try this studio preview. And I've noticed this fourth one works the best. And because the add-on uses viewport rendering, you can even further customize the look by using all these options. So let's enable shadows and cavities and let's change the direction of the shadows a little bit. And once you are satisfied with the look, you can simply hit this render option and it will save a copy of the render in the same folder as the blend file. So here it is inside the same folder as the blend file. And as you can see, it looks very crisp and clear. So that is basically it for the add-on. The links for the add-on as always are in the description below. So go check them out and I'll see you in the next one.